So welcome to part two of my small tour of Glentress. Part one's link is on the screen just now, and that involves some of the blues and the reds that I took my girlfriend round. So if you're a novice or you're just getting into mountain biking, then go and have a look at that, it might interest you. If not, and you're an expert or you're more confident or you want more entertainment, then this video I will be hitting some of the blacks, some of the off-piste, non-sanctioned trails that are available at Glentress. I like to call it the dark side of Glentress, so welcome to the dark side. So this is a shortcut. This does away with the spooky wood climb. It's very steep. Thankfully the e-bike, piece of piss. I walk this. If I'm cycling on a bike, I have made it to the top of this bit, but then it carries on and I had to stop. I felt like a hero for getting this far. Okay. This is where we split.
Oh, I'm doing spooky with thumbs up.
Oh. Yeah, I'm going left.
Okay, have fun.
Okay, enjoy. Be careful. Oh. There you go. Mast. Funny that. All good trails start at mast. Okay. First trail on the dark side of Glentress is going to be a trail fairy plan, it's called, and that leads on to fairy liquid. Now, trail fairy plan I have done twice. Not overly familiar with it, it's quite tough. And fairy liquid I have never done, but I'm going to hit that as well. This is easy. Mast is just behind us now, and you just drop in here. Straight into the good stuff. One big rut all the way down. Plenty of bumps. The only other two times I've hit it, it's been very, very wet. This is about as dry as it probably ever gets. Whoa. Yeah. Steep shoot. Oh yes. That's the game. Ooh. Oh, extremely steep. Oh, just made that turn. See a lot of trails, a lot of bike tracks going off on that corner. This could very easily be the Golfie, which is just along the road. Sorry about the brake noise. Literally just started there. That is hilariously tight. Wow, this is better than I remembered. Jesus. drop. Again. Oh, I think this is new. I don't remember it being like that before. Just worried about the camera. A wee wipe. I think it's all good. Oh. Oh yes. Straight out. Oh man. Okay, that was even better than I remembered.
Okay.
Found fairy liquid. I have no idea what I'm hitting here. Let's find out. Oh. Yeah, this is cool. Two lines there. The left here. Inside line. Wouldn't quite call it a black, but it's fun. Okay. So after a trail fairy plan and fairy liquid, I'm now almost back up to the mast. But because this is the second half of today's riding, I'm now done down to under 10% on my battery. Thankfully, once I get to the mast, it's for the most part all descending. So we should be okay. Cutting it close though. Right, back up at the mast. I'm now going to head round the boundary trail, and there's a couple of turnoffs I can take that are nice, natural, rough trails. First, we've got to do Carl's Lane. This one's quite nice. There's the reason it's called the boundary trail. From the distance you'll be able to see this wall is the boundary and that's the trail next to it, so yeah, pretty self-explanatory. Off camber again. Okay, this trail is called 5 Year Plan, and Bruin Droot is the next one. In the winter, this is pretty much pitch black. Still pretty dark in the summer. Oh. Steep chutes. Yes. Just watch those pedals. And bars. I could have went a lot faster, but I've been brave slash stupid to do so. Wow, it's like polished in there. Yes. Oh, almost. I just caught it. Stayed high. Woo. Who said e-bikes are boring? Because that wasn't boring. Here we go. Right, this one is called Bruin Troot, which for any non-Scottish viewer is brown trout. You know, the fish. Bruin Troot. I remember this being quite fast up here, and then it gets tighter. Oh, almost. Just checking I was recording. That would have been annoying. Aha, just made it. Oh, nice and tight. Rock round, bumpy traverse. I line worked out in that one. Test for the quad muscles if there ever was one. Oh, this has got very, very loose. Cut right back. Bumps, jump, whew. Oh, fantastic. Oh no. That's it, I'm out of battery. Oh, it's all down to me now. Got a long way to go. So the good thing about the specialised level is when you run out of batteries, you can cycle it almost like a normal bike. It disengages the motor. Obviously, you've got a heavy bike and just a little bit more resistance than normal. but it is doable. Okay, this one is called the Ewok Wall. It took me a wee bit to get up to speed, because I ain't got no power. I remember this one to be quite fun. Drops right in this corner. Up over this. Yes. Uh-oh. Not good at skinnies. Got away with that one. Yes. That one was called Double X that I just led on to there. And now we're heading for one I don't think I've ridden called the Bitch. This is it shoots off to the left somewhere. Okay. This'll be it then. Oh, sneaky wee line. Oh, that was a bad line. Yeah, I've not hit this before, I don't think. Yeah. Over the roots, yes. I don't have done this, I have done this. Oh! Now we go straight into Ponduro. This is the final descent. Oh. that's the handle for the gimbal. Gonna need that in the pocket. Something in the background there, it was the zip line going. Bit that never dries. I'm going to outside this time. Back. That's all I could show you with the battery that I had. Left in the gimbal, left in the bike even. There is more on the other side of the hill that I need to come back again for. The Strava will be in the description for this ride and also to my profile if you want to go and ride anything like this. If you want to see the full runs, then have a look at my Patreon page. There'll be extended cuts, if that's your thing. Anyway, good day.